On the School Watch tonight, what was one of the Central Coast's most financially troubled school districts, the Pajaro Valley Unified District. Well, district leaders now say the district is one of the area's most stable. Action News reporter Phil Gomez shows us why.
Watsonville High School teacher Tyler Jones is happy to be back teaching history. Last year, he was one of 122 teachers who received a pink slip but was rehired by the district.
It's exciting. Watsonville High is going through a turnaround process. We've applied for a Race to the Top grant and have received that. And the whole staff is working together so awesome this year. We're all on the same page with grading, with academic rigor.
Currently, we're one of the most financially stable districts in California.
Pajaro Valley Unified School President Leslie DeRose made that announcement Friday morning during the district's annual school kickoff breakfast. A few years ago, the district couldn't make that claim. Over the past 5 years, $18.5 million in budget cuts have taken their toll, with 15% reductions across the board, and some departments like maintenance and operations taking a bigger hit with a 25% cut.
There's a lot of enthusiasm for the upcoming school year, especially since the district is financially sound. However, there is some uncertainty, especially with a few tax measures on the upcoming November ballot.
We are in good fiscal condition, and it will be another challenge for us if the proposition doesn't pass and if we have additional reductions.
That would be State Proposition 30, which would raise the state sales tax by a quarter cent for 4 years and raise taxes on incomes over $250,000 for 7 years to help close California's budget deficit.
Over the summer, our board, on a 7-0 vote, passed an initiative to put the bond, a $150 million bond, on the November ballot. And we're really ramping up excitement about that, and we're really hoping that's going to pass so we can support our students.
Called Measure L, it's a $150 million bond measure that would repair infrastructure for schools. In Watsonville, Phil Gomez, KSBW, Action News 8.